Hello everybody, and welcome back to Let's Play Sins of the Solar Empire, Sacrifice of Angels 2. Well, there's that Borg cube. That level 10 Borg cube. And this system happens to be that little asteroid field. That's right here. I was wondering why culture wasn't getting there, and I thought maybe it's because there's a capital ship there. And that is true. There is one hell of a capital ship there. I'm surprised that ship escaped. I don't want to take out that. I want them to come to me, if anything. And, oh wow, I didn't realise I had so many resources. Let's pause the game for a second. And let's get some weapons and defences. That starbase right there. I did pick the right one. Yeah, one of my fleet. And let's put a couple defences around here. If you're wondering why I'm pausing the game a lot, it's because I don't want to not pay attention when my scouts arrive. I want to see what they see first hand. See the layout of the enemy homeworld and everything. If they get that far.
What is your command? A friendly fleet has arrived.
You worked there.
Confirmed.
You worked there. He's probably not going to make it. If they have a starbase at either of those planets, I doubt he's going to live much longer either.
What is your command?
Oh, no, they are completely vulnerable there. I like that a lot. Well, of course, that's an asteroid belt, so there's going to be nothing but one extractor there. And this ship is off to a good start. This planet probably has a lot of defences. Well, maybe not a lot, but a few. Probably a starbase. And that's probably it. Maybe a couple turrets. That's my guess anyway. Oh. Oh no. They have nothing there either. Very interesting.
Station complete.
If we can bypass here, we can take out all of that probably. Let's see what they have at their homeworld. Not much more either. Oh my. Oh my. This is very unlike the computer.
Ready for action.
They left everything completely defenseless.
Ready for action.
I kind of have a mind to try and blow stuff up with these guys. Don't know if they'll do much. Could cause problems if I had a defiant class with a cloak.
What is your command?
I could probably bypass this that place and start causing trouble. That is an idea. A doable idea. I'll consider it. But until
what
then,
is your command?
I'm going to remain scared about that. These guys could get the cube away.
Allied backup.
The Klingons could strap the Borg, get them to move their cube. Or even if the Borg just attacked me, that would be preferable.
Station complete.
Otherwise, I'm just gonna have to upgrade my culture. I'll upgrade my resistance to the culture, so theirs won't overtake mine. just in case they're spamming it.
A friendly fleet has arrived.
Maybe I should increase the spread rate. I think that's probably a better option. Cube is still there. I sent a sphere to... yeah. Okay. That's fine with me.
Ready for action.
Allied forces are being attacked.
What's my fleet composition like?
Ready for action.
Well, I could certainly try and engage the Borg. Okay. Let's see if... I suppose we'll get a road test of a steam runner. If the Borg were to attack. I'm almost definitely not going to attack them, because if they have a starbase and a cube there.
What is your command?
Station complete.
This doesn't look like a nice place. Oh, I'm surprised you escaped all those torpedoes.
A friendly fleet has arrived.
Okay, they're tickling these guys. And they've got it to level 6, which means it has the super ultra beam of death. If only there was an already destruct button. I'd have blown that ship up so fast. Well, the good news is they don't seem to want to attack me yet. The bad news is when they do, I'm not sure if I can hold them. Come on, Borg Cube. You don't have to stay there. You can leave and everything will be okay. Just move. Might as well get Federation Pride.
A friendly fleet has arrived. Comsat has detected inbound hostiles.
Yep, here it comes. Let's see what they... neutralize the colony on Eden. Is that... yeah. Okay. Well, we have incoming a few Borg ships. And our fleet is exactly in position to fight them. And it's within weapons range, which is good. Okay. So, this is how it's going to go. We're going to focus fire on the Borg cube, because it's the only Borg ship they're throwing at us so far. It's level 10, and I have a warp inhibitor, which should slow it down in its retreat. So this could be a very good thing that's about to happen here. Let's go. Bring it on, Borg.
What is your command? Attack pattern.
Ready
for action.
Fire everything you have.
Ready for action.
Fire at will.
Energy reserves critical stage.
Allied forces are being
okay,
attacked.
Okay, pause the game. I'm so used to spacebar pausing the game. Nemesis refit. Torpedo barrage. Yeah, this is going to be good. Okay. Unpause. Ha ha ha. Yeah. Take this, you Borg cube. should explode. Yeah, you made a mistake attacking me, you bum. Okay. Now,
Admiral,
we level up the Enterprise. And I think that they were the most scary things they had there, apart from the obvious starbase. Now I'm just gonna wait for my culture to rapidly get there and start taking over. Fleet is mainly over there.
A friendly
fighting a Borg as it should be. Okay, they have a few spheres there. Not sure if they're going to try and attack with them. Looks like they're going to try and attack the Romulans.
Research complete.
Okay, they're slowly losing there, which should mean now we have a decision to make. Do we charge in?
Standing by.
A friendly fleet
and fight
arrived.
That terrible, terrible starbase. Well, raise shield harmonics wouldn't go amiss. First of all, how much do we need for a larger fleet? 400. And 250, 1400. That should be fairly easy to come by. That'll happen any minute now. Then once that happens, we can board a large fleet with quite a few Akiras, and we can go in there and we can blow stuff up. But I've got to make sure the Borg are distracted. I don't think that fleet's going to be enough to take that on, but I don't think they want it to be. I think if the Klingons attacked a Trio 4 now, they could take it. As long as I would distract.
A friendly fleet has arrived.
I think I might go and help the Romulans once their colony is completely wiped out of defences. Yeah, help was a bad choice of words there. I will mop up the Borg attackers once the Romulans are dead. Because my ships really want to go through their territory and, well, I'm okay with that as long as they're dead. Although I can't account for most of the Borg fleet, and that is worrying. I do want to take advantage of their lack of defences up here. But I do feel if I were to jump there and jump across there really quickly, I don't know, I feel like I'd lose a lot of people and I would be vulnerable. Lord knows I don't need the Borg to take all that. Because it's given me quite good income so far. Funny thing is, I'm using my metal mainly to buy crystal. Now, do I want better torpedoes or better phasers? I'm kind of inclined to go phasers because they're used more.
Research complete.
I think that is the way to go, although more hull is tempting. I want more damage. Because the only way we're going to beat the Borg is by able to outproduce them. Okay, there's no way I'm attacking that planet now. They've got too much of a defense. However, if they want to attack me, I'll welcome it. Really, guys, please attack there if you can. Because it looks like these guys want my blood. If they could hit those with their passive regeneration, anti-passive regeneration rather, might be helpful. But as I said, I'll attack there once they've all died. They are losing culture rapidly, that's good.
And research complete.
Okay, I'm almost about to get that, so I should start preparing to build stuff. Let's see, a Kira class, Steam Runner class, maybe a Saber class or two. Yep, because I don't have any of those at the moment. I think I have enough Intrepid classes.
Research complete.
I think Saber classes will be very useful in fighting that starbase, because an extended shield would be quite useful. A Centaur class could be useful, but I think one won't do enough. So I'll go for another Steam Runner, then I'll focus my efforts on Sabers and Akiras. Kinda wish I had Nova classes, but
Allied backup has arrived.
That's something I'm okay with. Advanced shield scanning might be nice. I'm still not entirely sure about what it does, but I think it could be good. That could be great, but it's very expensive. Just for increased firepower and support. I don't know. I really still don't know enough about this game to know whether that's a wise decision, whether it's something I should be beelining for or just not getting. Sensor ghosting, good against non-computer players, but I'm not sure if it would work much against the computer. No, I think I'll stick with getting three or four Saber classes and a couple more Akiras. I think that'll work. And you know what? I think I might speed this up by doing some of this off camera. So hopefully next episode I'll have my fleet ready. So yeah, I'll see you guys next time.